Hi guys, welcome back to SG Dr. Wellness. My name is Dr. Chen Yiming. Today, we'll be talking about a serious condition called lung cancer. What is lung cancer? What are the types of lung cancers and what are the risk factors? What are the symptoms that suggest lung cancer and what can you do to prevent it? Watch till the end of this video. And if you are new to our channel, click on the subscribe and notification button now. In Singapore, cancer cases are on the rise, and every single day, about 39 people are diagnosed with cancer and 15 die of cancer. The number of cancer cases has increased by 6 times over the past 50 years. The lifetime risk of adults getting cancer in Singapore is 1 in 4, and is as common as hypertension. The good news is, with early detection and treatment, you can have better clinical and management outcomes. The top 3 cancers in men are colorectal, lung, and prostate. And the top 3 cancers in females are breast, colorectal, and lung. So today, we'll be talking more about lung cancer. It's amongst the top 3 cancer in both males and females. From 2013 to 2017, 14.5% of all cancer in men were lung cancers, and 7.6% of all cancer in women were lung cancers. It is the leading cause of death in cancer patients in Singapore, accounting for 26.6% of cancer deaths in males and 16% in females. Lung cancer is the uncontrolled growth of abnormal cells in the lungs. As the cancer cell grows, they can interfere with the normal functioning of the lungs. They can also spread from the original part of the lung to the lymph glands around the airway, the opposite lung, the bones, brain, and liver, as well as to other parts of the body. There are 2 major types of lung cancer: small cell lung cancer and non-small cell lung cancer. The diagnosis is made by how the cells actually look under the microscope. Small cell lung cancer makes up about 10 to 15% of all lung cases worldwide. It is an aggressive cancer which grows quickly and spreads early to other parts of the body via the bloodstream and lymphatic system. Due to the rapid spread, they are often diagnosed late, and treatment is mainly chemotherapy alone or in combination with radiotherapy for symptom control. This type of lung cancer is strongly associated with cigarette smoking. The second type are the non-small cell lung cancer, and they include squamous cell, adenocarcinoma, large cell carcinoma. Non-small cell lung cancer is not as aggressive as small cell lung cancer, but it is more common. It accounts for 85 to 90% of all lung cancers worldwide. It tends to grow and spread less quickly than small cell lung cancer. And if discovered early, surgery and or radiation therapy, chemotherapy may offer a chance of cure. So what are the risk factors for getting lung cancers? Cigarette smoking is the number one risk factor for lung cancer. It is responsible for almost 80% of all lung cancers in the world, especially the western part of the world. In fact, secondhand smoke is also a major risk factor of lung cancer among non-smokers. Secondhand smoke actually increases the risk of lung cancer by about 30%. Age. Lung cancer is more common in people above the age of 40. Personal or family history of lung cancer. Your risk of lung cancer is higher if someone in your family have had lung cancer. A lung cancer survivor is at a higher risk of developing recurrences of lung cancer. Air pollution. The World Health Organization estimates that about 4 million excess deaths per year worldwide due to air pollution. Those who live in more polluted cities have a higher risk of lung cancer than those who live in less polluted cities. Radiation exposures like radon. Radon are radioactive gas. They are actually found all around us in low levels. They are generally found in the ground, the soil, the rocks. However, there are some occupations which are exposed to higher levels of radons. Examples are miners, people who work in uranium processing factories, and people who come in contact with phosphate fertilizers, which may have higher levels of radium. Industrial exposures to harmful agents like asbestosis, arsenic, chromium, nickel, soot, and tar. Now, as mentioned earlier, the worldwide statistic states that smoking is responsible for up to 80% of lung cancers. But interestingly, in Singapore, and also noted in the Asia Pacific region like Japan, there is a marked difference between our statistics with the worldwide Western data.
In Singapore, we have a strikingly high proportion of lung cancer detected among non-smokers or never smokers, as high as 47.7% of all lung cancer from the 2011 data are in non or never smokers, as compared to the Western countries where lung cancer in never smokers were only 10 to 15%. And almost 70% of lung cancers in never smokers in Singapore are females. The reasons for this is still being evaluated, and there are some postulations that this may be due to genetical predispositions and exposure to environmental carcinogens such as radons from fuels used for cooking. The scary thing is that there are often no symptoms in the early stages. In the later stages, you may get unexplained weight loss and tiredness, loss of appetite, persistent cough with blood and sputum, breathlessness, chest pain, and frequent chest infections. So how do we prevent lung cancer? Quit smoking, or if you are a non-smoker, not to start at all. Avoid secondhand smoke, avoiding carcinogens at work, consuming more fruits and vegetables, and adopt a healthy lifestyle by managing your stress, exercise, and sleep early. Unlike, say, breast cancer or cervical cancer and colorectal cancer, there isn't any population-wide screening tool available for lung cancer at this point. However, there is a screening tool for high-risk patients in Singapore using low-dose CT scan of the lungs. For patients who satisfy the below 3 criteria, can have the lungs scanned with a low-dose CT scan. The criteria are smoking history of 30 pack years or more, where 1 pack year equates to smoking 1 pack of cigarette a day for 1 year or 2 packs a day for half a year, and who are currently smoking or have quit within the past 15 years and whose age is between 55 to 75. In future, when more results are available from future studies, this screening test may be expanded to also include patients between 50 to 75 years old who are East Asian females who are non-smokers or never smokers, those with family history of lung cancer, and history of exposure to known carcinogens and air pollutions. Treatment of lung cancers involves surgery, radiotherapy, chemotherapy, newer therapies like immunotherapies and targeted therapies, or a combination of all the above. So in summary, please do not think that cancer is uncommon. It may be more common than you think. In fact, it may be as common as hypertension. Do not ignore your symptoms and please consult your doctor should you feel unwell. Lung cancer is pretty common in Singapore. You need not be a smoker to be at a higher risk of getting lung cancer. There is a screening tool available for patients who are at high risk, but this screening tool is not indicated for everyone. Manage your lifestyle to minimize the chance of cancer. Stop smoking, reduce stress, sleep early, and eat well. Thank you for watching till the end of this video. Do like and share if you found this video helpful. Please click on the subscribe button now. Till the next time, stay safe, stay healthy.